again, being new here, I'm a little confused. Is it one, two, or three council members that are required to put an item on the agenda? I think I need a little clarification. I think Mr. Bond said that just one can do it. Did he mention that one has to be the mayor? Did you?
Well, one can give it to the city manager. You were right. One, two, or three can, yes.
I think there's some deception going on here. I think I'm just an average Joe coming in here for the first time, and other good citizens are clarifying it better than you. So what game are we playing? Is it one, two, or three? If the one is the mayor, then you should mention that. Otherwise, it's a sin of omission and a clear deception on the record right here on TV.
Well, if you'd save some of Norm's time, let me respond to that as a response to his question. To get rid of some of the confusion. It is one, two, or three. One council member can see the city manager and say something like, there's a street in my neighborhood that's got a problem on it. People have been after it for a while. Is there some way we can get that agendized? And the city manager say, yeah, we'd probably do that. When the city manager and the mayor meet, they'll put it on there. So that's one person, one council member. The two council members would be, as was pointed out, council member come talk to the mayor, and mayor say, sounds like a good idea to me, we can put it on the agenda, and you go ahead and do it. I, for one, have never been refused an item on the agenda, no matter who was the mayor or whatever. I don't put a lot of them on there. I let the city manager put stuff on in order to run the city. But the three comes from the Brown Act violation that was mentioned earlier. We do that in an open meeting. If at the end of this meeting someone says, I would like to agendize whatever, then at that meeting, in the open meeting, we would take three people, a majority, to nod their heads or have council consensus to put it on. Does that help you with the one, two, or three? And it pretty much states that in our practice.
Okay, I haven't studied it, but I was given to understand that what all this fuss is about is that it requires three people to put an item on the agenda, and one of the council members is shaking, nodding her head yes.
That's true. The two items that Tony brought up. Were brought up in a council meeting, I believe. Someone says, I'd like to redo the Hall House. I'd like to review that. Council had made a decision, I think, two times before that, and the majority of the council said, no, I don't think I want to revisit that, and we move forward. And the same thing was true with the other incident. It wasn't the Hall House, but was it the Pacific View. We've had Pacific View up here four times without anything, so I... was pretty well resolved by itself. But all I'm trying to do is explain that, my understanding of it. Now, the attorney and others can explain that maybe I'm off base in my understanding, but that's my understanding of the one, two, and three. And the three is a result of Brown Act. We, in order for three of us to do that, we have to do it up here.
Right.
And if someone suggests that we do it here and we don't have three, then we don't do it.
But you can do it with one or two.
Sure.
Not here.
Not here, yeah.
If the mayor agrees. You see what I mean?
The mayor or the city manager?
Or the city manager.
Okay.
Okay, I
was unable to explain it to your satisfaction, so I tried. Right. I'm sorry I didn't make it.
Okay. Thank you for your efforts. I'm for democracy. I thought that's the hallmark of America. And so I have a suggestion, since I'm confused about how I can get a topic on the agenda. If we can't have grassroots democracy at this level, on a small city level, then where can we have it? So why can't we have a law that says if 50, 100, 200 citizens sign a petition, they can thereby place a topic on the agenda? Why can't we have that? In case a tyrannical situation occurs through some freak of nature and all five council members are subverting the entire democratic process by opposing the interests of the entire city. It could happen. These things happen. So I'm suggesting we have this petition law as a fail-safe default process so that democracy can prevail. Thank you.
Yeah, I'm not done yet. Gosh, I'm getting a lot of advice from everybody what I should be doing. For my turn to speak, I just want to share some of the previous experiences I've had on this council. Early on, when I got on the council in 92 or 3, we had quite an active planning commission and quite an active group of folks who wanted to build everything and another group that didn't want to build anything and, you know, people in between. And we were bombarded with a city, and it wasn't a problem. So this probably won't be a problem. The only way it'll become a problem is if we have repeated requests for things that have been chewed over maybe once or twice, and it didn't come out the way I wanted it to come out, so I want to take another bite at the apple and agendize it again, crank off another 70 to 100 hours of staff work to put it on the agenda. If we don't abuse it that way as council members, then we're going to be fine. I could care less whether we're 1, 2, 3, and that's why I told Norm, it's all the above, 1, 2, and 3, and it's still going to be 1, 2, or 3 going forward, one way or the other. Now, we've got a motion in a sec. Well, 1, 2, and 2, and if we have in order not to have a brown conflict thing, we can have 2 at the open meeting, too. 1, 2, and 2, okay. But a worst case, 2. I don't think it's going to be a problem. Don't look for problems. If you look for problems, you can find them. If you want to find something wrong with your operation, give me a call. I can do it. But if you want to try to fix an operation or bring someone in to help you make it better, I'm all for that as well. So please do think from a positive perspective how we can make the process better, not how do we criticize this thing more to get my way gone. So I'm all for it. What I'd like first is the clerk to read the motion as they understand it, and secondly to ask staff if they understand what that is, and if you can bring back to us a rewritten philosophy and methodology for this proposal in a way that incorporates everything we've talked about and don't throw out everything else that was in there. Is that an agreement with the council? Is that your understanding?
That's my understanding. The only thing I think needs further clarity would be what Tony Kranz had mentioned, and that was if an item has been scrapped from the agenda, I'm not sure how we would ever know that. That language is really problematic, or the inclusion of it is really quite odd, so that might need a little bit more work.
Well, yeah, we could. You noodle on that, staff, because there's a lot of things that are scrapped before they even get there, whether or not they come from the council or the city manager or whatever else. Every time they have a meeting during the week to solidify the agenda, we do find that some items either do not need to be agendized or are inappropriate to be agendized. So we'll staff take a look at that and bring back some words to us to help us understand that that's not going to happen in a way that it goes off to the cornfield and no one knows what happened to it.
At the cornfield, it's a great place to be.
You know, a list of everything not to be agendized would be a very large book indeed. So that's a problem.
Okay, well, we have a motion and a second. Staff, did you read that motion? Did you understand?
No, I didn't, because I don't understand it. I'll read it. I was going to suggest that perhaps